make sure, because I thought I'd call you, because it came to my mind.
To make sure I got it out.
With your YouTubers?
Yeah, you are on speakerphone.
Hello!
Mom.
Okay, bye.
Okay, love you, bye.
Love you, bye.
Hey vapers, welcome back to my channel. Today's video, it's time for a vape vlog. Alright guys, so I know it has been a very long time since I've done a vape vlog, and I say that in every single one of my vape vlogs because I used to do them at least once a week, like in 2013, 2014. So now they're like more like once a month or once every 2 months. I don't even remember the last time I did a vape vlog, but I know it hasn't been that long. Like, I've gone longer without doing a vape vlog before. But anyways, let's just get into it. So I'm going to go ahead and test out an e-liquid because I used to do e-liquid of the week, but I obviously it's been way more than a week since the last time I did a vape vlog. And so I guess I could just tell you guys, well, like, I'm literally loving the same e-liquids I've been loving for a while, and the new ones I want to save for my favorites video, which is coming up in a few days because it's almost the end of March. So I guess I'll just skip e-liquid of the week. Like, I don't even know why I'm keeping that a thing. It can't even be a thing anymore. It's like, I don't do them every week. But I still have e-liquid. When a company sends me one bottle of e-liquid, I don't tend to make videos on just one bottle or one flavor. So I like to spotlight them here in the vlogs. And I do have an e-liquid to test out. This company called Backcountry Vapor sent me the flavor Campfire Nectar. And I don't know what it is. It doesn't say on the bottle. It just says selected by outdoorsmen for outdoorsmen. I am totally not an outdoorsman. I'm not a man, and I'm not outdoorsy, really. Like, I'm kind of like not even half outdoors. I was gonna say maybe half, but no, not even half outdoorsy. Like, I guess in the wintertime, I don't really like going outside. In the summertime, definitely like camping or rafting, floating the river, things like that. But I don't know what it is, and by that little description for outdoorsmen, I thought like, oh my god, this is gonna be some bold, burly flavor, but I am smelling butterscotch. So I'm gonna try it first, and then I'll go ahead and look it up and tell you guys what it is, because I kind of enjoy doing blind taste testings, just because it like really puts my taste buds to the test and my like e-liquid perception. But just by the name Campfire Nectar, I would seriously have to think that this would be like some sort of s'mores flavor. I mean, when I think of a campfire, I think of s'mores. Because, like, what else? You roast s'mores and hot dogs over the campfire. But this is definitely smells. It has to have butterscotch in it. So, yeah, we're kicking off the vape vlog with an e-liquid testing. And then I'm going to get into questions and shout-outs for everyone. And so on and so forth. So, let's... It smells really good. I'm like, here's hoping. That was very underwhelming vapor production. Why is this not giving me vapor production? I guess I can turn up the wattage a little bit, but just shit, can't turn it up too much. This is a 1 ohm coil. A little bit better. Okay, so there's definitely has to be butterscotch. Like, if there's not butterscotch, then there's something wrong with my taste buds and my nose. I'm smelling butterscotch, almost kind of like toasted. Like, maybe it's a s'more, because but I'm not getting chocolate. I don't know. My mind is screaming, it's gotta be s'mores. But also, I'm all like, at the same time, why would an outdoorsman s'mores? Like, this doesn't fit with the description. I don't know. I'm gonna look it up because it's driving me crazy. I wanna say it's like slightly a s'mores flavor with butterscotch on it or something. But I know that it can't, I don't know. It's just my brain is, you know, one side's like, it is this. And the other side's like, no, it's not. So Backcountry Vapor. It's funny because like I probably totally live in the backcountry. Like, what would be considered the backcountry? Because I live up in the mountains. Cannot verify server identity. What does that mean? I don't know, but my phone did not like that. What the heck? Why is this Miss Magazine? Oh my gosh. Are they not even a thing anymore? Because that was like the little ad that says like, you can secure this domain. That would be so sad, because that flavor is pretty freaking good. Three juices. Well, let me see what the three juices are. Aha! Campfire nectar. When the ever-pleasing sweetness of drizzled toffee is combined with a rounded, soft, creamy custard fullness in the result of campfire nectar. Wow, so it's toffee custard. I was so wrong. I'm like... God. I mean, I guess you could smell toffee, but I smell and taste butterscotch. I guess the marshmallow played into the fact that it's a custard, but I was off. Off, but the flavor is delicious, and that's what it tastes like. Like, it's supposed to be toffee custard. I get, like, butterscotch marshmallow. All right, so time for some questions and shoutouts. I did ask you guys on Facebook and Twitter if you had any questions for me, vape-related or non-vaping related, and then I do have some questions from, YouTube as well. So let's see this, and these YouTube questions or shout outs are pretty freaking old, as are almost all of mine when I do these, because I look for them and then I don't do a vlog for like I look for questions and shout outs and then I don't do a vlog for like 2 months. Shane Smith says, hey T, great video, been a while since I seen a vlog. See, this must have been at the last vlog. He says, 2 years Sunday smoke free. Well, congratulations to you. I know that your 2 year was probably like 2 months ago, but congratulations nonetheless on being smoke free. That is awesome. Linda Schaffer said, where did you get that Hello Kitty cup? I want one. So she's referring to the Hello Kitty cup I drank my water out of in the last vlog, and I actually got that from Maddie at Bonsai Vapor, or probably the whole group, but I know Maddie knows I like Hello Kitty, so like she probably helped pick it out, and that's where I got that. I got that as a gift when I went over and did the Vapor game show with them. That was really fun, and I would love to do it again. Okay, next we have For Your Information TV. Says, hey Tia, I love all your vids. Love the hair too. Thank you. I notice you have social anxiety. Do you have anxiety disorder? Yes, I do. I have suffered from anxiety disorder since I was a young kid, and now, unfortunately, my 17-year-old has it as well. I'm curious if the slime you make helps with your anxiousness. I know you, that's probably strange, but I'm looking for ideas to help her cope when she's anxious. Maybe it's a sensory calming too. Yes, that is why I started making slimes and doing slime videos on this channel, because I was watching them on Instagram and YouTube, and I'm just like, oh, they're so relaxing, and I just love watching. They're so satisfying, like the colors and glitter mixing. I freaking love it. And so I was like, I want to make some on my own. Like, I want to put in like my little flair and slime and make my own slimes, and it's just so much fun. I literally have a slime on my desk. I have like a slime sitting out in my living room. Like, I have just like slimes just randomly, and I just pick them up and I play with them whenever I want, and like when I'm anxious or something. I don't tend to take them with me though, which is when I would probably need it the most, because I get my anxiety most when I'm out, because I have pretty bad social anxiety. And I don't take them with me because I did do that one time and the slime container opened in my purse, and like it was a disaster. I even found like, what was the other day? Oh yeah, I was opening my wallet and I found like a dried piece of slime in my wallet. I'm like, oh my God. So I learned my lesson. I don't take them out, but I do have them all over the house. Like, I just have so many different kinds, and I've been selling some of them. Some people like on Snapchat were super interested, and so I do sell them. And if that's something you guys are interested in, I could totally make like an updated video on what slimes I have right now, because I have a lot of cool slimes, and I have some clear slime, what do you call it? Settling, because you have to let the bubbles settle. I just got a text message from my husband. And so I have some clear slime setting. I'm going to do some glitter mixing and stuff. That's like my favorite. I love glitter mixing, or like foam bead mixing, or I need to get the crunchy fishbowl slime pieces, but I want to get the exact right ones for it, and I haven't been able to find them in real life. But anyways, sorry you have anxiety. It sucks. And I hope that maybe by now you've already tried the slime situation. Let me know if it worked for you. Let's go on to the next one. We have Andrew Gillespie. Oh God. The whole last name thing. I should just skip it. Is your text tone Kim Possible? Because mine is too. Yes, my text. I'm going to be really real right here. I was just reading that, and then I'm like looking for my phone to pick it up and show you guys that it's the Kim Possible ringtone, and I'm actually holding my phone, so that's a blonde moment if I ever had one. But yeah, my phone actually just went off. You guys heard it. That is the little Kim Possible communicator, what's the sitch, you know? So that, I just absolutely love that little text tone, because it's like, get a message, you know? It's not Wade on the other end, but Jacqueline Pratt said, this is probably a stupid question. I want to stress that there are no stupid questions in vaping, but could there be any chance that you're allergic to something in one of the many e-liquids you try? Okay, first of all, let me take a vape because I need one. I've been holding this. I'm like, okay. No, this was probably in regards to the fact that the last time I did a vape vlog, I probably talked about my hives that I had for a really, I had like really bad hives for about 4 to 5 days, I believe, and it was so miserable, and I was like, what am I allergic to? And I was going to get an allergy test, which I will talk about that too. I don't think it's anything an e-liquid at all, because I don't feel like that would give me the hives. I don't know, like, hives are either like a contact allergic reaction or like it when you eat something, because then it gets into your bloodstream. I don't know. I am not a doctor, so actually I have no idea, but I don't think it's anything vape related, because I vape all the time and I vape lots of flavors all the time, and I haven't had the hives since, like, fingers crossed it never happens again, because that was miserable. Strawberry Kisses asks, how do you clean your vape tanks? Could you do a video on that? I could do a video on that. I don't personally use tanks. Like, I will use the Axiom, or now I've been using the Scion with my MVP4, but I don't tend to use tanks specifically. I use my Cupti. It's an all-in-one, and I've had lots of people ask me, how do I clean this? And it may be like really terrible, but you might think it's terrible, but I don't clean it. I don't. I mean, like, I'll change out my coil when it needs to be changed, but other than that, I have not cleaned that. Is that gross? Like, is that a thing to clean out, like, your tank? I never did it when I used tanks either. Like, I would just keep filling them up with e-liquid, but, like, if that's something I should be doing, someone should let me know, because I've been vaping for going on 5 years, and I never really had, like, a tank cleaning routine or anything. Like, I guess I'm just a gross bitch. But if people want me to make a video on how to clean out different tanks and whatnot, I could totally do that, because, like, I'm sure you could just stick a Q-tip down in there and, like, swab it out with some alcohol or rinse it out with water. I don't know. Mr. Rocco Marchiago. Wow, I did not say that right. Says, oh yeah, meant to ask if anyone else vapes in the shower. I don't vape in the shower. Does anybody out there vape in the shower? That, I wouldn't recommend that unless you have like a waterproof mod, and even then maybe like still keep it out of the water. I wouldn't recommend it, but I think there is actually, I think, a couple waterproof mods out there, but as far as the atomizer part goes, I don't know of any like waterproof atomizers. Mark Bruno says, where do I buy new coils? And I do buy new coils for the Cupti and the Axiom from directvapor.com. I will leave a link below to that if anybody out there is interested in where I buy my coils. They do have so many, like, they probably have most of all the popular tank coils, and even some of the older ones too. So I'll leave a link below to that. Victoria Grace says, can you do an e-juice collection video? Now, as far as like e-liquid that I have, that I buy, or, you know, that's sent to me and that I really like, that's pretty relatively small, because, like, the flavors that I get sent to do e-liquid videos for, and if I like them, they're usually gone within a few days, because I, you know, I have one bottle of them, whereas e-liquid that I love, like Pounded, I have so many bottles of Pounded, like, so my e-liquid collection video would be mainly Bonsai Vapors, Pounded, and You Got E-Juice, and Bonsai Vapors, Milk Plus, and some just like some random few e-liquid flavors that I've gotten from companies to do videos on. And then e-liquid collection, as in all the e-liquid I have in this room, would be ridiculously long, because I have so much e-liquid to still make videos for, like, so much e-liquid, like, months worth of videos in e-liquid to make videos for still, so stuff that I have not tried. And then everything else that I try and I don't fall in love with, I give away to friends, or I donate to my local vape shop, where they then give it to people who are like down and out and need, you know, a bottle for free. And then Samara Scarlett is asking, could you sell them on eBay? I'm pretty sure she's either referring to e-liquid that I don't vape, or devices that I don't use anymore, or, you know, don't, because I literally, this is my favorite device. Like, I use this 97% of the time. And my answer to that is no, I will never ever sell my e-liquid or vape things for profit. I did do an auction a while ago for a couple unopened vape things that I had in order to raise money to help my friend whose car was stolen and broken into and her baby's car seat was stolen. Like, who does that? And they replaced that stolen brand new nice car seat that she just bought for her daughter with their old tattered stained gross car seat from whatever car seat they had for their child. Like, they just swapped her car seat, broke her window, broke her seatbelt, broke some other things in her car, like stole the keys. It was ridiculous, but like Vape Fam pulled through and we were able to raise enough money to cover all of the damages and to replace the car seat, which was like a $300 car seat. So that is the only time I've ever like sold, but I auctioned my extra vape stuff off in order to help somebody. And I will never sell it for profit for me personally. I've never been about that. Even people in my life, like my actual real life, are like, they're smokers and they come to me and they're like, hey Tia, can I buy a vape off you? I'm like, no, you can't buy a vape off me. You can have one for free and you can have e-liquid for free. I've never ever sold e-liquid or vape equipment for profit for myself. But speaking of doing auctions, I'm gonna do something else kind of like that. It's going to be a vape giveaway, so it's not gonna be an auction. You don't have to buy it. It's gonna be a giveaway. But because my giveaways are always so easy, which I am going to be announcing giveaway winners as soon as I'm done talking about this, because I almost forgot. So my giveaways are always easy. You just have to like and comment on the video. But this time I'm going to ask a little bit from you guys in order to start this giveaway. I have a friend who is going to be in a modeling competition and there is a public vote and I want to help her get past the first round of public voting. And so I'm going to introduce you guys to her and do a video about her little modeling like photo shoot that we did that was so much fun. And then basically if you guys can get her enough votes, because I know there's thousands of you, if you can get her enough votes to put her through to the next round, I am going to be giving away a bundle of vape stuff. And she actually makes soaps and like bath bombs and things like that on the side from what her regular job is, and she's gonna put together like a bundle basket for, we're probably thinking two winners if she gets through the round, because there's thousands of entries. And but I want to help her out with votes, and since I have a large audience, I can probably do that. So that's not even like close to what I was doing for the other friend, because I was actually auctioning off for money to help for my friend. This, all I just want you guys to do is go to the website and vote for her, and if she gets through, then we're gonna do a big old fun giveaway. But let's do the giveaway right now for this, the MVP, and then two people are going to win the Honey Doo Doo and the Raz by Dr. Sugar Shits today. Right now. So I'm actually doing it on my phone this time because I forgot to do it on my computer, but I have the URL for the Dr. Sugar Shits video and I'm going to click load comments. Is it gonna do what it does on the computer? Yes, it is. So it's loading, oops, my best friends. It's loading all of the, my best friends again. All of the comments, and now they're loaded. Oh my gosh, my phone's blowing up, sorry guys. And I'm going to pick a random winner, so I hope I do this right, or we'll have to do it all over again. There is the random winner. Maybe, let me see. You rich, Tia Vapes? That comment doesn't win. I told you guys specifically you had to tell me your favorite fruit vape flavor in your comment to be a winner. So we're gonna pick another one. Let me see, do this backwards. Okay, that one says clouds, bitch. LOL, I love it. Again, sorry, that's not a winner. Okay, next. Okay, here's a winner. Tony Sargent. I like to win, but did try their watermelon one. It's so good, you should try it. I didn't know they had a watermelon one. That's gonna, I'm gonna count that one, like, even though it's still not technically telling me what your favorite fruit vape is, that one still counts because they said watermelon. And next says, oh, this one doesn't say. Next. Aha, FJFX Gaming says, strawberry as always, been my favorite flavor. So those are the two winners. I will be commenting on your comment and getting your email information so that we can correspond and I can send those out to you guys. So congratulations on the Dr. Sugar Shits winners. Now for the MVP. And what did I say you had to do about the MVP?
Or Scion Kit giveaway. All you have to do is, after subscribing to this channel, giving this video a thumbs up, I want you to share it somewhere on social media, then comment down below.
Now I remember what I told you guys you had to do to win. I had to double check. So we're gonna get that, and then we're gonna go back to the homepage of sandracries.com, Sandra Circus, I don't know, paste, and we're gonna load the comments. Is it going? There we go. Doo-doo-doo. There was a lot of people in this giveaway. And, okay, I gotta make sure I do this right. Gotta do it backwards. Oh my God, this does not say, you had to say where you shared it or you wouldn't win. And I'm sorry, but cool mod, I know it's cool, but you don't win, that's not a winner. Oh my God, why are all of these comments not winners, guys? Okay. Person number two. Said they would love to win it, but didn't tell me where they shared it. It's like people aren't actually listening or watching all the way till the giveaway part, and they just see giveaway in the title and then comment something down below. I'm sorry, but that's not gonna win my giveaway, my rules, and you didn't follow them. So hopefully third time's a charm. Oh my God, that's my own comment. What the so dumb. Picked a random comment and it picked my own freaking comment. That's just ridiculous. Okay, we'll try again. Okay, let's see. This person said finally. Okay, Crystal Seward. I love Innokin products. Haven't had the pleasure of owning an MVP yet, so it'd be great to win. Well, you won. Thanks for the chance and another great video. Shared it on Facebook. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Let me screenshot that. All right, girl. So I'm assuming you're a girl because Crystal, but like if you're not, oh my God. Assuming genders. JK, so you are the winner of the MVP. Oh, it's not by my side anymore. I was going to grab it. I'm going to comment on your comment. On this one, I'm going to comment on your original comment, girl. So if you're watching, I really hope you're watching. Then we'll figure out, you know, I need your email and your address and your all that good stuff. I mean, hopefully you're paying attention to the giveaway stipulations or whatever to win. Back to questions and comments. There's another one. There's quite a few. And this is just YouTube. So Laura Sergis says, what are your recommendations for first time vaping? I definitely recommend something easier and smaller to people that have been smoking for a while, like the MIG Sig 21 or the MyJet or the Juul. Like those tiny little Sig-like things, I definitely recommend. And I'm actually going to be looking at the Juul shortly this week, so I'm like excited to check it out because I did do the MyJet and I kind of like messed it up. Like I didn't realize what I was doing, but it still worked really great. And I did loan that out and it has been helping my friend that I've loaned out. I just want to wait until maybe they haven't smoked for like 2 months and then have them come on and talk. I think that would be fun, but they gotta make it, you know, 2 months. Janet Laney says, what is your favorite mod? I'm in serious need of a new one and you seem to have a lot. If I haven't said it enough, the Cupti by Kangertech is my favorite mod and it has been since like July of last year. So almost going on a year. And I have yet to have anything beat my love for this. Lara says, do you ever think about having children sometime soon? Yeah, I would love to have children now that Doug and I are married and we are in the process of building a new home. I would definitely love to have children. So whenever God blesses us with a baby, then that'll be it. But like, yeah, I definitely want to have kids. So anytime now, I would be happy to have a child. Wait, oh my God. So I just, like, 2 questions ago answered this lady's questions. And then she's like, comments again and says, why don't you ever answer any of the people that follow you? Have you been on Twitter, Snapchat, or Instagram, or Facebook? Like, I am always chatting over there and answering people's questions. Everyone knows that's where to go to get a hold of me, especially Twitter or Snapchat. And I answer YouTube comments rarely because I get so many, and then I do save them and put them in this vlog. So you must be new, but I just answered your question, so I just like debunked your little you don't ever talk to us. And then wait, she goes on. We keep your channel going. It would be better if you would interact with us. I wanted to ask you a couple questions, but I see you haven't answered any other questions, and that's all in caps. I don't think that the way to keep a good vape channel. Please talk to people, answer our questions. But I literally just answered her question in this video. And like I said, I answer everybody on Twitter and Snapchat all day long. Like every day I'm on Twitter, every day I'm on Snapchat answering people. So like, you need to get a Snapchat or Twitter really, or just look and wait for these vape vlogs. And I tend to not answer people that are rude to me, that say like, you never talk to your viewers, when I talk to my viewers a lot, every day. So, sorry. Okay, so those were all the questions from YouTube. Now, before I move on to questions from Twitter or Facebook, I don't know which one I'm gonna look at first, probably Twitter, I love Twitter. I just also wanted to mention that HR1136, I know I've been talking about it a lot and tweeting about it and posted on Instagram. So that's the new thing that everybody needs to get behind. It's like the revamped Cole Bishop, and it's going to help us a lot if everyone just gets behind that and call your local state representatives, everyone within the US obviously, call your local state representatives and urge them to support HR1136. That is so important. All right, now over to Twitter for some questions and everything. We have at Amy Coomer, how do you feel as an animal lover about SeaWorld and Project hashtag empty the tanks? Well, this is the first time I'm ever hearing of hashtag empty the tanks, but it sounds good to me. If it's about freeing the animals that are trapped in SeaWorld, then I am all about it. I went to the San Diego Zoo for my honeymoon. It was one of the stops we made on our honeymoon, and it was cool to see those animals, but it was also really freaking depressing to see that they were so tired and just like not, they didn't seem happy. Lots of them were sleeping, like maybe I was there at the wrong time and they were all just napping, but like it was sad to see those majestic like wild animals trapped. And so like, I've never been to SeaWorld. I've heard some crazy things about SeaWorld, and I guess I just don't support it. I mean, like, I would never go there. I don't have any interest in going there, like, after all the things that I've heard. And I think it's sad that the animals that should be in the wild, but then there's the argument that, like, if they were in the wild, they'd already be extinct or dead. And which, you know, as somebody who doesn't go there, I don't go to zoos. Like, the San Diego Zoo was the first time I've ever been to a zoo in, like, since I was a little kid. So I don't really go to zoos or like aquariums like that, but like I think just because I am an animal lover, like I'd rather them be in the wild, I guess. But then the argument about then they'd be extinct, so it's like pick your poison, like be trapped and alive or wild and then like caught for somebody's vanity wall, which I'm against that. Like people who hunt wild animals like elephants and stuff for the ivory or like, you know, for the fur, I don't agree with that. Personally, I was a vegetarian for 4 years of my life, and then I was vegan for 6 months, but that wasn't me. I like dairy too much, specifically yogurt and cheese. And I know there's vegan options for that stuff too, but I was vegetarian for 4 years of my life, but I'm an omnivore, so I can't be a vegetarian anymore. But definitely I support, like, if you're gonna go hunt an animal, then you need to eat all of it, use all of its parts, like that's what it's intended for. If you're gonna go hunt an animal specifically to hang up its fur in your little trophy room, I don't really support that, because those poor animals, like how would you like being hunted for your fur? But like that's kind of a topic that's like there's some of those topics that you just like don't talk about, like politics and religion. Like you're supposed to leave that kind of stuff off of YouTube, because half of your audience is this way and half of your audience is this way, so half is gonna agree with you and half is not gonna agree with you, so you can't please everyone. But I mean, I'm gonna be honest and open, like about the SeaWorld thing, like I would rather those animals in the wild, I guess. But we can have a calm, mature adult discussion about it down in the comments below if anyone has a different point of view. I would like to see it. Right, who's next? Next we have Anthony Neal saying, is the V-God 50 watt good, and why don't a lot of people like smoke? One, I don't know if the V-God 150 watt is good because I've never tried it, and two, I can't speak on why other people don't like smoke products. I don't know. Actually, from my point of view, a lot of people love like the Smoke Alien and the TFV tank line. I was under the impression that everybody freaking loved that. So I can't speak to your question on why you say, why don't a lot of people like the smoke. And then this person, Matthew Johnson, says, why haven't you reviewed the Kanger 160 drip box? Is that this? Is that what this is? Is this the, because I got this. I got the drip box too. Is that this 160? We'll find out when I look at it. It might not be. I mean, the reason I haven't looked at it, I mean, there's not like actually a reason, like I'm not avoiding it on purpose. I have so much other stuff right now that there's just so many products. I guess it's because I didn't know it existed. I think it's that. Maybe it is that. Maybe it's not that. Maybe it's another. Like, maybe there's three drip boxes. Maybe there's four. I don't know. Like, I find out a lot about new products through you guys. Casey Hendershot says, down from a pack of stinky sticks to three a day. Congratulations. I'm hoping the Cupti will help me make the switch completely. Any advice? Woo, congratulations. I would say, for as far as advice, like, if you're getting a craving, try vaping higher nic. Or investing in one of those little closed tank systems like the MyJet or the Juul that have a really high milligram with a tight draw like a cigarette. Maybe invest in one of those and use those when you're really craving a cigarette instead of this, because this is not like a cigarette at all. But I do love the Cupti. Hashtag Team Cupti. Alright, who's next? At Voidman1 says, when are you and Doug thinking of making little ones? You would be such a great mommy. You can tell that you have a lot of heart to give or love. But he used the heart emoji. But thank you so much. And I did already answer this question. We are, you know, we'll have babies when it happens. I wanted to definitely wait until after marriage to start trying to have a family. And now we got married in September. And we're building a house in June or July. And so whenever it happens, it happens. And we'll be as ready as we can be for it. So thanks for asking. At Gabby Vapes says, can you update us on your new house plans? Well, I just kind of just did a little bit right there. We are in the works to crack the ground in June or July. And then a house takes what, probably like 6 to 8 months at the most, I don't even know. But we'll be living with my mom and stepdad, so I'll be living with Mama Vapes because she just bought a house not too far from me, and it has 3 extra bedrooms, so plenty of room for Doug and I, and an entire separate living room area, so that will be really nice. And we'll live with them, and then the animals, the dogs will come with us, the cats will stay on property, and we will put like a little shed in the back corner of our property where there'll be like a bed and food and everything that they can go in and out. And you know, we'll see them every day because we're right down the road, but I can't, obviously there's no way I can move 5 cats down the road. They'll just come home as cats do. So that's that plan. No, like, I don't got much details in it, only because like there's so much details that go into building a house. I know we've got our lender picked, we've got our builder picked, we just like, now we're just like going through the loan process. And so yeah, it's a long, I'm stressed, like, I'll make like a separate video and I'll like list things, but like the rest of the video would have, this video would have to be about the house stuff if I was to explain like all of the updates. But it's coming along and I'm really, really excited to have my own house. I mean, I do now, like, this is what I'm living in, but it's not, what is the word, preferable to live in this place. I want it torn down. It's very old. At Survival Chick says, want to try different flavors. New atomizer every time equals money. Have the iStick Pico now. Cupti ordered. Best way to switch flavors a lot. Oh, do not. You should not have to buy a new atomizer, like a new tank, every time you switch a flavor. Oh, no, no. You just switch the coil. And I've had this question asked before, and I've probably answered it the same way before. I literally just vape through flavors because most of the flavors I vape are the same, like, range. They're sweet and yummy, and so I just, like, when my Cupti is very pretty much empty, I just fill it up with either the same flavor or a new one, and I just vape it through until it's the new one, majorly the new one that I'm tasting. So I mean, if you're one of those people that can't stand to mix flavors, then changing a coil would, I guess, be your way to go. But you don't have to change the whole atomizer. And I don't know if you're meaning atomizer, because when I think of atomizer, I think of tank. And I don't know, maybe you're just meaning just the coil. but definitely you don't have to change tanks. Changing the coil would probably be the best way if you don't want to mix flavors. Or you can get like this flavor switch stuff that I've seen some other vape YouTubers use, that they, it's just like, it's no flavored, it's like PG and VG but no flavoring, and you vape it until your coil's clean with it and then you put a new flavor in, I guess. I've never tried it, but I've heard of it. So really quickly, I'm actually going to show you guys, I forgot, I do have a little bit of vlog footage of me going to my local vape shop and donating all my old e-liquid and mods from 2015 and 2016. So I'm going to show you guys that now, because a lot of people were like, why didn't you just give it away? Well, I did. I gave it away to the vape shop, who are then in turn going to give it away to smokers who come in who may not have the money to buy a full setup. They can get it for free there. The vape shop assured me that they are not legally allowed to resell anything that I donate, so that it will all be given away, and that's wonderful. So I did give it away. I just didn't do it online.
All right, guys, it is Sunday, and I just called down earlier to one of the other local vape shops here in my area, since my favorite one have closed down, and asked them like how they would feel about a donation, because you know, some shops might be weird and like they don't want any used stuff or any e-liquid like that. And so I called down and asked them if they would like a donation, and they said yes. So, and the owner's not in, but the manager is there. The owner's rarely ever in. So we are headed down to donate all of my extra mods and tanks and all the e-liquid I couldn't vape in 2016, just like I kind of did last year, but not at all like I did last year, because last year I did a big giveaway and announcement and had people come and take as much e-liquid and stuff that they want. We're not doing like an announcement or anything. I'm just donating it to this shop, and like hopefully they'll give it out to people, like the e-liquid, hopefully they'll give it out to like vapers, and the mods, hopefully they'll give them out to people who come in and may not be able to afford a mod, but I don't know really exactly what they're gonna do with it. So like, here's hoping they do something that I would want them to do with it, but who knows. So yeah, see you guys down at the vape shop. And I've never been to this one before. I just typed in vape shop and like my area to find the other vape shops, since my favorite one closed down, and there was three other ones. Two of them didn't answer twice, so like one day I called and the next day I called and they didn't answer, so I called this one and they answered the one day, but it was just like a regular employee, and I wanted to call back when the manager or owner was there to speak to, and they were there today and they sounded really nice on the phone, really pleasant. So yeah, we're on our way.
All right, this is the shop we are going into, Cloud 509. I'm so happy to find out that this shop is going to be giving away everything that I'm donating. So anybody that comes in that may not be able to afford something, whether they're a smoker looking to make the switch or a vapor that just needs some extra juice, they are going to get their pick. How exciting. I'm so happy. So I hope you guys enjoyed that little bit of vlog around footage. And really quickly before I forget, so if you've been a part of this channel for a while, you'll know that my favorite flavor of all time is Pound It by Bonsai Vapor. It's an iced lemon pound cake, not to be confused with Pound It by Food Fighters, e-liquid, I believe that's what it's from. This is Pound It by Bonsai Vapor. It's part of their active line. It's so good, and a part of the proceeds when you buy it are donated to notblowingsmoke.org. And then the other flavors, like, I think, Pinky Swear, I think, goes to the Pink Lung Brigade, and then the other one goes to the American Vaping Association, I believe. I'm not too sure on the other two. I know one does go to the Pink Lung Brigade, but the Pound It proceeds, part of the proceeds go to notblowingsmoke.org to help with vape advocacy. But not only is that like the most amazing part of that being my favorite flavor in the world, but I also have a coupon code for you guys, finally. It is just TIA20, and you get 20% off your order of Pound It. That is only applied to Pound It, so you can't go to Bonsai Vapor and buy the other flavors and use my code. It is specifically for Pound It, for my favorite flavor, TIA20, for 20% off your order. So if you have ever wanted to try Pound It at a discounted price, there you go. Or if you want to buy it again at a discounted price because you like it, there you go. I am so happy that they had come out with a coupon code for me, because I have been loving that flavor for, I think this is, because it was in my favorites of 2015. I think I discovered it in 2015 and I've loved it ever since. Like, best flavor, in my opinion. And while we're on the topic of Tia's favorites and stuff, I also do have some flavors that I created. Now, they definitely, Pound It is still my favorite flavor ever, but I gotta, like, you know, toot my own horn with the flavors that I created at the Vamana Vapor Bar. I will leave a link below. I did create 4 flavors. We have Crazy Vapey, Clouds Bitch, Vape Queen, and Vape Kiss, and they are all, like, super sweet, desserty flavors. I basically took my favorite flavors and, like, mixed them together, except I did not. People were asking me, like, oh, why didn't you try to make a Pound It copycat for my flavors? And there's no way, like, I'm not gonna do that. I love Pound It. It's perfect. It does not need to be copied by me, especially. So there are these 4 flavors, and out of the 4, Vape Queen is my favorite, and that is a coconut vanilla cupcake. So it's like a vanilla cupcake with coconut frosting. It is so freaking good. I have butterscotch and marshmallow, strawberry and caramel. There's a horchata flavor, so I will leave a link below to those as well if you want to check them out, and a link to my merch. Like, hella shout out for myself. Like, don't I deserve it sometimes? This is my Clouds Bitch shirt. There are other things. There's Clouds Bitch hats, mugs, there's other shirts, like, with my face on them, my little cartoon character. I have those too, but, like, I love my Clouds Bitch shirt the best. So if you want to check out any of that merchandise, I will leave a link below. So I will link below to Pound It with my coupon code. I will leave a link below to my e-liquid creations, because that's the closest thing to a TiaVapes e-liquid line that's ever gonna happen, I'm pretty sure. And then I'll leave a link below to, like, my little merch shop, which is a spread shirt shop, which I love. It's so easy to create stuff on there. And for anybody wondering, also, I totally forgot to mention this when I was talking about my allergy test. My allergist person that I was recommended to, hang on, I got a hair. He said that he didn't want to rack up thousands of dollars worth of allergy testing, because most of the time they don't find what it is if it's not the usual, like, nuts, fish, you know, the main types of allergies people have, which I said it's not, because I've literally been eating that stuff that day, like, that I went into the office. So he didn't want to test me and, like, rack up this bill just for me to not find out, because sometimes it's idiopathic or something like that, which means that they have no idea why it happens, it just happens. And so he said that if I had broken out in hives again to come in, but if I don't, then I'm probably good. And I never did since then, like, fingers crossed it doesn't happen. But I did want him to test me for salmon, because that was the only thing I hadn't eaten in a long time, and then I'd eaten, and then a few days later I had the hives, but I wasn't allergic. So I was tested for salmon and trout, because that's, like, the main fish that is fished where I live and that I eat, and it was neither of those. So that's the only things I was tested for. I mean, like, he was telling me, like, each little prick is, like, $40 to $60, and there's, you know, you could have hundreds to find out. And I was like, yeah, okay, you're right. And I guess you've been doing this for 20 years, he said. So I actually didn't get an allergy test, so I just gotta add that in there real quick before I go over to Facebook and answer your questions over there. Alright, there's not many questions over here, so that's good, because I think this late vlog has run a little bit long. Says Lee Watling. My god, this hair is stuck to my lip. I got it. Just so you guys don't think I'm crazy. Like, I got it. Do you see it? Oh my god. There it is. Anyway, Lee Watling. Hi Tia, massive fan. Can I get a shout out, please? And my question is, well, shout out to you. What is your favorite e-liquid from the UK? Thanks for all you do for the vaping world. You rock. Well, thank you. And I'd have to say, that's really hard to think of off the top of my head, because I get mainly American e-liquid, but I think the Dinner Lady, isn't that might be Canada. Well, I think it might be, I think it's the UK. It's the Dinner Lady e-liquid, and it's so freaking good, and I actually have a new flavor by them to try, so that would be my favorite UK that I can think of right off the top of my head. Like, that's the first one that comes to my head. Now, there might be one that I tried that I'm totally forgetting of, and I'm like, oh my god, I love that stuff. But when I think of UK e-liquid and good, Dinner Lady is the one that pops into my head. Sherry Townsend says, what's your favorite candy e-liquid? I don't actually tend to vape candy flavors really, but like I like butterscotch and caramel, so I guess G2's Mr. Cookie, but that's a cookie flavor, so it'd be like considered a dessert flavor. I used to really like Nikwid's straight up fresh butterscotch. Oh, Yummy Nectar's butterscotch. I loved that stuff when I had it. It was so good. So I guess that's a candy because you can have like those little hard butterscotch candies. Stephen Gibbs says, how you going with your handgun, Tia? Good. I still have it, and I'm actually going shooting with my friends this weekend. So yeah, it's going good. I love it. Love my little Sig. Sig Sauer, not Sig cigarette, but Sig Sauer. It's a gun brand. Joshua Duran said, where did Cloud's bitch come from? That's a good question. And you know what? I don't think I can take full credit for it because basically what happened was, so everybody knows that Grim Green says Clouds broke Clouds. Like, he coined that little term, and I used to say that too because I was like, oh yeah, Clouds broke Clouds. But then it's like, I was like, that's just not, it's too bro. Like, I don't ever say bro. I don't say bro. I don't say dude. I don't talk like that. And I was just like, you know, that's too manly-ish for me, you know, like Clouds bro. Like, I mean, good for Grim Green, like I love it, and you can say it to me and like that's cool, but I'm gonna respond with Clouds bitch because like I'm a girl, so I'm a bitch, I'm not a bro. So that's where it came from. I guess it was because like I liked Grim Green's little Clouds bro Cloud saying, but it didn't sound right coming out of my mouth, you know, because I'm like, I don't say bro or dude ever, but Clouds bitch, like bitch, yes, that works for me. Erin Laughlin says, what other passions do you have, like things that interest you? I love animals, anything to do with the Titanic, and makeup, especially nail polish and eyeshadow. Well, I do have a lot of other interests, and I feel like people who, you know, have been on my channel for a long time and really watch all my videos would really know this by now. I really love making slime, and I love cooking and baking. I love trying new recipes, especially trying new cooking, like dinner recipes. I love to do that. Chicken is my favorite, and I can like make chicken anything. I love Harry Potter with all of my heart. Like, this isn't Harry Potter, but it's little Newt Scamander from Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. I love Hello Kitty. Like, I always have something like Hello Kitty or Harry Potter in the background of my videos because I super, super love those things. I also love Fall Out Boy. Like, these are things I feel like, oh, everybody knows, but because you asked specifically, like, I could sit and talk about Hello Kitty and Fall Out Boy and Harry Potter all day long. I am really getting into makeup as well, doing makeup videos. I love my animals. I have 7. I have 2 dogs and 5 cats. As far as, like, hobbies go outside of, like, things, I really like to go hiking and floating the river. That's something we do around here. I love going camping. I'm actually going camping in 2 weeks, and I'll probably do a vlog for it, but I really have that kind of passion, and I love to make videos. Like, I know that's like what you do YouTube, obviously, but like I do mainly vape videos, but I love to do other videos. Like, I love, that's why I do on the weekends. My weekend uploads are reserved for non-vaping videos if I want to, where the weekdays are all vaping, but the weekends are reserved for my other passions like slime and cooking and makeup, because I just love to make videos, and being able to make new ones and have fun with it, like with the cooking or like do vlogs. Like, I'll have this week, I'll show you guys a little video montage that I did for my friend for her modeling thing that I mentioned earlier. I really enjoy vlogging and making videos. I guess I don't know how to really else put that, but I mean, obviously I'm on YouTube, I love to do it, and that's why I wanted to branch out and do more on this channel. And running 2 channels, I used to try to do that, it was so hard and it wasn't worth it. Like, my second channel was just so neglected, and just it, no, that's why I merged my channels, because I want to share my other passions with you guys, because I love making videos. It's so fun. Andrea Waite, I don't know if that K is silent or not, but she says, what if your future children smoked? Wow, what a good question. So, if my future children smoked? Well, if they were 18 or older, I would definitely try to get them into vaping. But if they were younger than 18, and I say I want to be like, oh, you know what, if they're younger than 18, 17 or younger, and they're smoking cigarettes like I did, I want to be like, oh, I'd take those cigarettes away and I'd ground them when I caught them and I would smell it and blah, blah, blah. But like, that never stopped me from smoking when I was underage. Nothing stopped me. I could get cigarettes from older people, and even getting in trouble and stuff, that never, it never stopped me from smoking. So would it stop my future children? I would just hope that they wouldn't, but like, both of my parents were smokers, and I know that it's not like, oh, if your parents are smokers, you're gonna be a smoker. I know it's everybody's different, and you could have parents that weren't smokers and become a smoker, because I'm not a smoker anymore, and Doug's not a smoker, so my kids wouldn't be exposed to it firsthand at home like that. But there, you know, there's the rest of the world, like, you know, peer pressure and stuff. Like, oh, that's such a hard question, because my instinct is like, they're gonna get in trouble. Like, I'm gonna take their cigarettes, I'm gonna, you know, break them or whatever, flush them, or like make them smoke the whole pack. Like, you know, the traditional what parents say they're gonna do to their kids if they smoke. But none of that works, I don't think. At least it didn't work for me. Like, getting in trouble for smoking didn't work for me, and I started smoking when I was 16. I guess I just have to, at that point, if they were younger and they, because I wouldn't condone children's vaping either. It's just it's a hard area to go into, because you don't want them to smoke, you don't want them to vape if they're underage. But if they're underage and they're smoking already, like, isn't vaping still better? But like, you know, that's a good question. That's a good question, because like, I don't know. I guess I just have to, like, you know, educate them on what smoking does. And even still, we all know what smoking does. We know it causes cancer and all this stuff. It doesn't stop people, really, most of the time. That's a good question. I'm gonna have to ask Doug. I'm gonna go ask my husband and be like, what would you do? Because like, he never smoked cigarettes. I did, and now I vape, and he doesn't vape. What would I do? I don't know. Great question. And last question of the vlog, because this vlog is running entirely too long. Lummy Stokes, how come you decided to become a vaping blogger? So I decided to become a vaping blogger basically because I'd always been into YouTube. I've always loved YouTube, and I've always, since I was in, you know, middle school, I think, like probably seventh grade and up, I've watched YouTube channels. So I've like grown, like, Live Lava Live was my first YouTube channel that I was obsessed with, and I was also obsessed with the Fred channel and Jenna Marbles, and I've always loved YouTube. And then when I got introduced to indoor smokers through my dad, because they are best friends, my dad is Mike, and he's always on indoor smokers videos, not always, but a lot, he wanted my opinion on an e-cig because I was a smoker, but I was also a female and he's just a male. So he wanted, you know, I was like, I think I was his first guest appearance, or female guest appearance maybe, on his channel to give the opinion of the e-cig. And then we just did that together. I did collabs with him on his channel before I ever made my channel. And then Indoor Smokers was like, you know, you're really good at this, like, on camera. Like, you should try to do it. And, like, you know, try to quit for real. And, like, you know, vlog your opinion on these e-liquids and these vapor devices and try it out. And I was like, okay, sure. So it just really went from there. And he helped me through all of everything. He, like, if it wasn't for Indoor Smokers, this channel would not exist. Because I probably wouldn't have found my way into YouTube. And now that I'm here and I've been doing the vaping videos and I'm like being able to branch out, I'm like, okay, here's my other things that I like. It's just, it's literally the best thing. I absolutely love to make videos. Like I already said, it's so much fun to me. I love editing. I mean, like, that's tedious, but like, I love editing and making things look perfect. Like, especially when I do vlogs and I add music and, you know, vlogs of my real life. Like, when I did my honeymoon vlogs, that was so much fun to do. And then I get to relive, you know, my trip, my honeymoon. That was so much fun to get to share that with you guys and vlog. I don't know. I like being on camera in my house. I don't think I would ever do, like, TV shows or anything like that. I'm way too scared for that kind of stuff. But I just love doing it. I love talking to you guys. I love having this audience that just watches me and like agrees with me on things and then puts me in my place when I need to be. Like, it's really awesome. YouTube is an awesome thing to do. Okay, so my battery is actually about to die. That was the last question that we had so far. I did just only ask this morning. But I also wanted to make a little thing about my channel's on the restricted list. So if you are ever wondering why you're unsubscribed from my channel, YouTube does that. It's a thing that YouTube does, because so I've had some people say, oh my god, like, I'm all of a sudden unsubscribed from your channel and I didn't do that. That's a YouTube thing. Restricted mode, my channel does not appear in restricted mode, so make sure you're not in restricted mode or you won't see any of my channel. It does not appear. Like, I am on the restricted mode, and I think that's because it's vaping, and vaping is so much correlated in the media with smoking and tobacco that I think that's where that came from. And I think almost all of the other vape channels are blocked on restricted mode, except for, I think, like, Mike Vapes wasn't blocked. Like, I checked, like, all of the well-known vape YouTubers, and it seemed like all of us were blocked on restricted mode. So that kind of sucks. Thanks, YouTube. But at the same time, it's an optional thing. You just have to go into your settings and change it out of restricted mode. But yeah, that's it for the video. I know this was just mainly me talking to you guys and answering your questions, but I hope you guys enjoyed it anyway. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Give it a thumbs up for vape vlogs. If I get enough thumbs up, maybe I'll do them more frequently. Subscribe to this channel for more videos. Turn on the bell notification so you don't miss a single video, because being a subscriber does not mean you're going to see all my videos, and I upload daily. Check the description box below for all the important links of everything I talked about in this video. You can follow me on almost any social media site like Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, or Snapchat. All those social media links will be below. And one more thing before you go, if vaping is something you're passionate about, join CASA.org, fight for your right to vape, support HR 1136. So as always, I'm Tia, and thank you so much for watching.